In this video, we will take a look at the characteristics and presentation of cervicogenic headache. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. Headaches can manifest on their own, but are also a very common symptom in neck pain patients, as more than 60% of patients with a primary neck pain complaint report having concordant episodes of headache. Therefore, it is essential to find out what kind of headache the patient is suffering from. To start off, let's differentiate between primary and secondary types of headaches. But what does this mean? Simply put, primary headaches are a disease themselves, whereas in secondary headaches, the headache is a symptom of another condition. So, primary headaches would be migraines, tension-type headaches, cluster headaches, and something called medication overdose headaches. Secondary type headaches are headaches caused by tumors, hemorrhage, other trauma, TMJ dysfunction, or by disorders in the cervical region. Now let's take a closer look at cervicogenic headache, which is, as previously mentioned, a secondary type of headache. Cervicogenic headache has a prevalence of 0.7 to 4%, and as the name suggests, it is a headache caused by a disorder involving the cervical spine and its bony, disc, and or soft tissue elements, and is usually but not invariably accompanied by neck pain. In order for a headache to qualify as cervicogenic headache, it has to fulfill certain criteria. First and foremost, there will be clinical, laboratory, and or imaging evidence of a disorder or lesion in the cervical region known to be able to cause headache, such as, for example, the facet joints or certain muscles. Furthermore, at least two of the following criteria have to apply. Number one, the headache has developed after the onset of the cervical disorder or lesion, so patients will probably describe a trauma during patient history. And number two, the headache improves or resolves in parallel with improvement and/or resolution of the cervical disorder or lesion. Number three, cervical range of motion is reduced, the pain is movement or posture dependent, and headache is made significantly worse by provocative testing. For example, decreased upper cervical spine rotation, as assessed by the flexion rotation test, can be linked to cervicogenic headache. You can watch this assessment by a click on the info icon in the top right corner of this video. Number four, the headache is abolished after diagnostic blockade of a cervical structure or its nerve supply. Tools you can use to assess the impact of a headache on your patient are the HIT-6 questionnaire, which you can find in the video description. Also note that it can be difficult for a patient to answer all of the questions on duration, intensity, and characteristics of their headache during your assessment. Therefore, asking them to complete a headache diary can help in the assessment and then appropriate management of the headache, and you should be aware that there can be an overlap between multiple types of headaches at the same time. Okay, in the intro I mentioned that headaches are quite often associated with neck pain, so be sure to click on the playlist right next to me, which discusses the neck pain guideline by the KNGF from the year 2017. Please check the links in the video description to learn about ways how you can support us in running this channel. Follow us on other social media pages where we post on a daily basis. Give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you're new here. And as usual, this was Andreas for Physiotutors. I'll see you next time. Bye.